Hair follicle miniaturization. Have you ever heard of it before? If you're experiencing a lot of shedding, thinning around your edges, maybe even in the crown of your head, and you don't know why, you are suffering from follicle miniaturization. You could kind of be doing it to yourself. In this video, I'm gonna explain to you what it is, how you're causing it, and how to reverse it. So if you want all of the information, you know, then keep on watching. Listen, I'm gonna be bald lashed out here and I can't see, but we're gonna make it happen because this little reflection thing is getting on my nerves. Hair and scalp miniaturization. What is that? Hair and scalp miniaturization is the shrinking of the hair shaft and eventually the hair follicle. Hairs around the hairline normally go into this phase first. So if you do not handle it right away, it can be permanent. And it goes undetected, A, because most people have never heard of it, and B, because its symptoms match regular patterns of thinning and balding that we see all the time, like traction, alopecia, and things of that nature. This is why whenever someone tells me, oh, Sin, I'm experiencing this problem or this issue, I tell you I need more information, because there are so many different reasons for thinning, balding, and shedding. Let's get into some of the causes. Hair monetization and genetic alopecia are directly connected. Let's talk about that. In this video right here, we talked about your four stages, well, more like three stages of hair growth. So you're gonna be lost. Go ahead, pause this, and then I'll wait. I'm gonna just sit here until you get back. Did you watch it? Bit. The phases that are affected most by your hair miniaturization are the anagen phase and the telogen phase. It shortens the anagen phase, which is the growth phase of your hair, where your hair grows, which lasts anywhere from 3 to 5 years, whereas the telogen phase is the phase where your hair sheds and falls out. The hair shaft is shrunken, and as it shrinks, it also shrinks the follicle, which in return gives you the appearance of thin hair. It also changes the pigment and the melanin base in the hair, so the hair begins to look a little see-through, a little bit more transparent, which in return also gives you the illusion of thinner hair. The most common type of balding in the anagen phase would be, you know, male pattern baldness. In the telogen phase, the version of hair miniaturization will be called this. I'm not about to say that right now. I'm not. I already passed and got my certification. This also leads to shortening of the hair strands, aka breakage. So not only are your strands getting weaker and more transparent, a little bit more fragile, they're getting more fragile, which is making them easier to break, and it's shrinking the hair follicle. So instead of you having maybe 3 to 4 strands per follicle, you may have one really thin one. In the long term, this will result in dead hair follicles and permanent hair loss, and this will lead into different forms of alopecia if the body is not nurtured in the right way and the proper steps are not taken soon enough. This disorder right here that takes place during the telogen phase, in short, is basically when your hair stays in the telogen phase for too long. This is a direct symptom of someone that is going through hair miniaturization. What are these causes? The first cause is that word that I'm not gonna say, and basically that just means that your hair is spending too much time in the telogen phase, which is the phase in your hair growth cycle where your hair begins to thin and shed and all that stuff. Your hair just spending a little bit too much time there. Number two, male pattern baldness. With male pattern baldness, basically in short, you guys, a man's body is just receiving a little bit too much testosterone to certain parts of the body. Number three, this is something that a lot of you will not want to hear, but nutritional deficiencies. This is major. When most people go into their hairstylist, they just want to come in like,
okay, girl, I'm growing my hair for this amount of time, and it say you supposed to grow 6 inches a year. Sin, do this work. Okay, I don't know what it is. this, like, I've been doing everything right. I used this product on my hair and it didn't even work.
What you guys have to remember is what you put inside of your body is almost more important than whatever products you're trying to put on your scalp or on the hair shaft. Because understand that hair growth starts on the inside. At the bottom of the hair follicle is a hair bulb, and that hair bulb is attached to blood vessels, and the blood that is running through your veins needs to contain a certain amount of vitamins and nutrients, just the body in general, to make sure that you're able to complete each growth phase the way that the body intends for you to do. But if you are doing different things like blocking the follicle or shortening your growth phase, you could possibly be sending yourself into this disorder without knowing. This is why I tell you guys to only pick products as it pertains to your porosity, and not just because somebody looks cute with it and you think that your hair matches. The very last one will be aging. As you get older, the natural processes that your body is supposed to take get a little shorter, your body get a little lazy, start feeling like you don't want to do it. So in that case, this is directly linked to number 3. You need to make sure that the things that you are putting in your body are making up for the things that your body is losing as you get older. And the truth of the matter is, whether you're 21 or 57, every day you get older. So tomorrow when you wake up, you're gonna be older than you are when you're watching this video. So you need to make sure that you are putting into your body what it needs. So how can we combat this? I know that's what you want to know. I'm not just gonna at you. I'm gonna give you some, you know, some stuff. So the first thing you can do is take supplements, or my favorite, different herbs. A list of all of my favorite herbs. Make sure you check my blog post linked in the description box below so you can see a list of my favorite herbs. And I have a new ebook for you guys breaking down the key amino acids that your body needs to make sure that you are on track for each growth phase. In this ebook here, I break it all down. So make sure you check the links in the description box below to get your copy now. Number 2. You need to go ahead and block the 5-alpha reductase enzyme. You can read it. We're not going through all that. I'm trying to make this video short. Relish mushrooms and saw pimento have been scientifically proven to lower the acidic base in the body and on the scalp. I've always told you guys that it is so important to limit the amount of acidic based products that you are putting on your hair, because if your hair is already in this state, then the last thing you want to do is put acidic based products in the hair, because these 5-alpha reductase, they thrive in an acidic environment. They need a highly acidic environment to function properly. So if you're a person that lives and thrives on apple cider vinegar, you are shrinking your own follicles slowly over time. I know that a lot of these at home products are great, and I know that you guys really want to make your own products yourself, and I have no problem with that. I'm an herbalist. I love things from this earth, but you need to make sure that the properties and the formulas are okay, because if you don't, you raise the pH level and you raise the acidic base. You are literally feeding it. It's like add fuel to the fire. The next thing you need to do is remove DHT from the scalp. I want us to sit on this, because I tell you guys all the time how important it is to clarify the scalp and to cleanse the scalp. I'm not beating anyone up, but here on YouTube, there's so much misinformation going around. I am on the main reason why you guys haven't seen me during my normal schedule is because I've been doing my one-on-one coaching calls, and almost every woman that I talk to is really under the misillusion that you're supposed to go months without washing your hair. And the truth of the matter is, your body was made by a master creator, and there is a process that your body has to follow. So when you block the hair follicle and when you do all of these different things like lock methods and all of that, what you end up doing is blocking the natural rhythms that your body wants to follow. And that's something that cannot happen, family. is something that cannot happen. I know you're probably wondering, what is DHT? It is of the male hormone testosterone, and it is the complete and total enemy of the hair follicle, and it's something that your body produces naturally. So to say that you're not gonna wash your hair for a month is really, really not a good thing. That DHT on the scalp, literally, it just wants to kill the hair follicle. It's a whole hater, okay? So when people say, oh, well, I'm gonna go all of this time without washing my hair, you are literally having your hair follicle commit suicide. And I know so many of us are like, oh, my auntie was doing this, or my grandma did this for all of these years. But I also want you guys to remember that most Black women have these same types of baldness. Most Black women that I am talking to on these coaching calls, or just most Black women in general, are dealing with the same patterns of baldness over years. Down the generations, most of the time, all of our aunties have the same types of balding patterns. And it's because we follow the same types of hair growth patterns, family. DHT has to be cleaned from the scalp, because over time, and when I say over time, I mean in a week, DHT, along with the sebum that your scalp naturally produces, along with the heavy, thick oils and butters that you're putting on the scalp on a regular basis, combined with the dead skin cells that are supposed to fall off of your scalp on a regular basis. When all of these things are combined together, they result in death of the hair follicle. And that is where this disorder comes from. I'm not making anything up. Everything that I ever talk about in any video can always be Googled and research, because after all, is YouTube is owned by Google. So everything that I'm saying, you can type in and research. I love you guys. I've spent over 14 years educating myself on this, and I've already done the work. So I really need you guys to understand that there is a science to your body and there is a science to hair growth. So let's talk really quick. There's this ongoing thing that Black women specifically do not have natural oils coming from their scalp, and that could not be further from the truth. Here on the screen right now, this is how things look under your skin. And do you see this that says sebaceous gland? Well, the sebaceous gland is located near the hair follicles, and they have the function of secreting sebum. Sebum is the natural oil that comes from your scalp. Your body naturally creates its own oils. The sebum comes out of the scalp, and it is meant to protect the scalp and the hair shaft from environmental damage and different things of that nature. So the key in growing your hair is simply keeping the scalp and the follicle clean and clear, so it has easy oxygen flow, so that way all of the sebum that is being grown, that is being produced within the sebaceous gland near the hair follicle. And as you can see, the sebaceous gland is connected directly to the hair follicle, and that oil comes up. But if you look, by you putting heavy butters and all of that, you see that little hole, it goes within the follicle, and you have this whole entire follicle blocked. So if you could imagine, that blockage goes all the way towards the bottom of that hair follicle, all the way near to the very, very, very bottom, to where the blood vessels are connected. So all of those butters and heavy oils and all of that, it blocks the sebaceous gland as well. So the reason that you have really, really dry hair and things of that nature is because the oil that your body is making naturally cannot come out, because you're putting oils and butters that are not meant for the scalp on the scalp, which is blocking your body from performing its natural patterns. Your body is perfectly made, but we don't know how to work things. We don't know what to do, because most of the things that we are doing to our scalp is preventing our body from moving in its natural patterns. Okay, so I really hope this did things. I'm not trying to be confrontational, but I have had this conversation with so many women over the last week. It's not true. The sebaceous gland, look it up, Google it right now. The sebaceous gland is located next to everyone's follicle, no matter matter the color of your skin, your body produces its own oil out of the sebaceous gland, and it is called sebum. And if you stop blocking the hair follicle, it will come out. Okay? I really hope that makes sense.